indeed, sir. But I know that in County Wexford they've almost annihilated an entire detachment of Norfolk militia and local yeomanry.
29th of May. Troops under Sir James Dark have killed 350 insurgents at the current capital there. But Wexford Town has been taken by the rebels.
We've taken heavy losses at New Ross, sir, but it appears we've beaten them back. I confirm reports of the slaughter of innocent Protestants at School of Bow by retreating rebels. Oh, the Lord Edward Fitzgerald has died.
Henry John McCracken has issued a proclamation calling United Irishmen in Ulster to arms. They've attacked Antrim but been heavily defeated. McCracken is on the run.
Wexford insurgents advancing towards Dublin have been beaten back at Arthur. Another group led by Henry Monroe have also been defeated at Banner Hinch County Down.
The Wexford insurgents have been finally defeated in Vega Hill.
Once a while, a sense the acumen, the thread of your onward flame. Henry John McCracken was tried, found guilty, and executed on the 17th of July, 1798.
In August, a French force of about 1,000 under General Humbert landed near Killala, County Mayo. After routing surprise British troops at Castlebar, they proceeded as far as Ballinamuck, County Longford, where they surrendered to Lord Cornwallis on September 8th. In October, a French squadron under Admiral Bompart killed the British under Sir John Warren outside Loch Swilly. Aboard one of the French ships was Theobald Wolfetone. He was arrested on landing at Kilmainham, County Donegal, on November 3rd. Tone was tried and convicted by court-martial in Dublin and sentenced to death. He requested his right as an officer in the French army to be shot rather than hanged. When this was denied, he slit his own throat with a razor and died a week later.
His aims, noted in his journal some years earlier, reflected what we struggled for.
To subvert the tyranny of our execrable government, to break the connection with England, the never-failing source of our political evils, and to assert the independence of my country. These were my objects. To unite the whole people of Ireland, to abolish the memory of past dissensions, and to substitute the common name of Irishman in place of the denominations of Protestant, Catholic, and Dissenter. These were my means.
Some 30,000 people were killed during the rebellion of 1798. In the 18 months that followed, almost 600 more were executed and a slightly greater number were transported.
The legacy of failure was bitter division. Atrocities on both sides hardened sectarian attitudes and begot traditions that still divide us today.
Oh, so glad.